I can't open this. Can someone help me?
I can help.
Get out. You're not a bivalve.
Wait, I thought I was.
No, let me explain. Have you ever heard about bivalves?
What about shellfish?
Well, all bivalves are shellfish, but not all shellfish are bivalves. This is a bivalve.
This is a bivalve.
That is not a bivalve.
Bivalves have two shells that open and close. You would be surprised at how much bivalve seafood we eat.
From small shellfish like Olympia oysters and scallops all the way to large bivalves like gooey duck clams. All these bivalves come from different parts of the world. Gooey duck clams are most popularly eaten in Canada, while in south of France, oysters are a common dish. Scallops are also an important bivalve because they are the most popular Japanese seafood in the world.
These delicious bivalves are filter feeders. This means that they are similar to small pumps that take in water from one side and out the other. As the water passes through the bivalve, these shellfish absorb oxygen, capture food like plankton and algae, and extract nutrients from the ocean. This makes bivalves one of the lowest trophic level aquaculture species on the market.
Mussels are an example of a below trophic aquaculture species that is highly sustainable and also promotes biodiversity. Many fish and shellfish utilize the artificial habitat created by mussel farms, increasing the area's biodiversity.
Offshore bivalve aquaculture, also known as open ocean aquaculture, is really important. Bivalve aquaculture's sustainability is unmatched, as it has one of the lowest greenhouse gas emissions associated with any protein on the planet.
Bivalves tend to be grown or produced in places with good water quality, appropriate salinity, and away from cities and population centers where pollution is common.
An interesting fact is that the environment actually affects the way that they taste, and depending on where oysters grow, they'll have a more complex flavor. Warmer water could mean quicker growth, but bland meat.
And cooler water might take some time, but yield sweeter results. The sweeter results come from the glycogen or sugar levels that are in the bivalves and can be different depending the time of the year and their reproduction season.
If there are a lot of aquatic food sources in the water, then bivalves can have similar tastes from improved nutritional intake. How does this relate to the food on our table? If you find good tasting bivalves, you can use them in a way for everyone to enjoy.
You can also put bivalves in your pasta, steam them, and grill them or bake them. Oysters are even eaten raw.
Have you ever had oysters on a half shell?
From eating oysters and other bivalves, you gain protein, zinc, vitamin A, D, and B12, making them an excellent choice for delicious and nutritious seafood.
Thank you for diving into the fascinating world of bivalves with us and their use in sustainable food production.
Bivalves!
Bivalves!
Bivalves! Bivalves!
That is not a bivalve.